Hey ServiceNow developers, Earl Duquet here, and I've got good news. Our annual Build With Challenge is back for its fourth year, and this time it's all about Build With Build Agent. Before we start, some of you are just looking for a how-to or a what to do if you run out of prompts. This video does have chapters, so be sure to check out the description, and if you're in a hurry, just jump to the section that you're looking for. This is your chance to vibe code with ServiceNow and see just how fast you can build a fully featured app using Build Agent. Okay, so what exactly is Build Agent? Think of it as your AI-powered copilot for app creation in ServiceNow. It writes your code, organizes your files, fixes errors, and builds both the logic and the UI all from natural language prompts. You describe what you want to make and Build Agent handles the rest. It's fast, it's smart, and it's built right into the ServiceNow platform. This year's Build With Build Agent Challenge is all about putting that power to the test. We want to see what you can create. Join the challenge to get hands-on with ServiceNow's most innovative AI development tool, share what you've built, and earn some exclusive swag and recognition in the ServiceNow community. Here's how to join. Step 1. Get started. Head into your ServiceNow IDE and utilize the sidebar to chat with Build Agent. From there, you can create a brand new app or edit an existing one using natural language. You can use your company instance if it's licensed for Build Agent, or request a personal developer instance or PDI from developer.servicenow.com. It's free and comes ready to go with Build Agent already preloaded. Step 2, document your experience. Once you build something, share your journey. Post a quick video, or an infographic, or a short write-up of at least 300 words showing what you've built and how Build Agent helped you get there. Share it on social media, like LinkedIn, X, YouTube, wherever you want, and make sure to include the hashtag #BuildWithBuildAgent so we can find it. And then step 3, share your post on the official ServiceNow community blog for the challenge. Add your link in the comments and include a short description of your app. That's how we'll track participation and make sure you get your rewards. And speaking of rewards, you'll get exclusive swag delivered straight to your door and a special Build With Build Agent badge on your ServiceNow community profile. A few of the most innovative and impactful submissions will also have the chance to be featured in the ServiceNow app gallery. So if you're looking for bragging rights, this is your moment. To qualify for the swag, make sure you submit by November 24th, 2025 at 11:59 p.m. Pacific. If you're outside of the US, shipping might take a little longer and swag is only available while supplies last. If you need help getting started, we've got you covered. In a moment, I'll show you a quick walkthrough of how to activate Build Agent and start building. You'll also find FAQs and resource links in the blog post with tips for creating your submission, using your PDI, and managing prompt limits. And yes, there are prompt limits. PDIs get 10 prompts per month, while licensed instances get 25. If you do run out, just release your PDI and request a new one to reset your usage. And I'll show you specifically how to do that later on in this film. If you get stuck or have questions, the Now Assist forum and Build With channel on the SN Devs Slack workspace are the best places to ask. You can also email us at buildwith@servicenow.com. Just note that response times can vary and we'll be monitoring the community comments for official entries. Okay, so to recap, activate Build Agent, build an app, and share your experience with the hashtag #BuildWithBuildAgent, and then post your link on the community blog by November 24th, 2025. You'll earn swag, a community badge, and maybe even a feature in the app gallery. We can't wait to see what you build with Build Agent. If you're excited to take part of this challenge, hit like, subscribe for more content from the ServiceNow Developer Advocates, and start building today. All right, stay hungry, stay humble, and I'll see you in the challenge. Cheers. Okay, so we are at developer.servicenow.com, and we are signing in to create our new account. If you don't have an account already, this is the process that you're going to do. If you do have an account, go ahead and just sign in with your ServiceNow SSO. Once you sign up, you'll get an email that's asking you to verify your email address, and then you will go ahead and confirm. And then the crucial step here is that you're going to wait until you get an email saying that your instance is ready. Until your instance is ready, you won't be able to continue, so just wait for that email. And then next, you'll know your instance is ready when you go to developer.servicenow.com. And you'll be able to see that you have your PDI assigned to you, and you will have the Manage My Instance button. So that's how you know you're ready to get started. Once you're ready to build with Build Agent, you will be able to start just from the developer.servicenow.com homepage, and you'll be able to start with a prompt inside of this text box in the very middle of your screen. You'll see here in the text box that I am creating a Boba inventory tracking app. Once I'm ready, all I have to do is say create. It will open up my personal developer instance directly into ServiceNow IDE, create a workspace, and immediately start building my app. That's how easy it is to get started. During critical moments of Build Agent, it will ask you to approve its next steps. And so once you press approve, it starts building things. I'm going to fast forward through this app, but I'll display how much time has passed on the screen for you. As Build Agent starts building your app, it will go through a bunch of different things like building your tables, building out a folder structure for you, building the dictionaries for those tables, creating scripts, creating different files that will help create the app that you requested. It'll even run diagnostics and attempt to deploy it to see what errors might happen during the build process so that it can correct itself if it has any errors that it didn't account for while doing the initial build. It tests itself, and it makes sure that it's something that can actually launch on your ServiceNow instance. When it finally finishes and is ready for it to be launched into your ServiceNow instance, it will ask you to deploy, and you can press approve. When the first prompt is done, you'll see it actually will tell you its progress and what it did during that initial prompting that you asked it to do. You'll see here that in this Boba inventory tracking app that I asked it to make, it created several tables, automations, sample data, and listed all the documentation for what it did, including key features for this application, should I want to document this elsewhere. I can navigate to these tables inside my ServiceNow instance, but I can also just ask Build Agent to do it for me. I can say, provide me links to all of these tables, and it'll give me these links and also provide some instructions on how to test this application. And you'll see here, I'm able to click these links and it brings me directly to the tables. I have all these four different tables that I'm looking at, including inventory, stores, transactions, and some of these tables even had sample data. One thing I did notice when I was opening one of these forms is that I'm getting an error at the top of the form letting me know that something is not working. With Build Agent, I can vibe code it out. I can copy that entire error and tell Build Agent, hey, when I load a transaction form, I'm seeing this error, and I can copy and paste that entire error or even my console logs that show this error and let Build Agent do the work itself to fix it. It fixes it, builds it to see if there's any errors, and then waits for me to approve it so that I can move forward again to deploy it to the instance. Once done, it tells me what it went through to fix, and I can jump back in to the form. And now I see that the error is gone. So it was able to fix it just by letting it know that there was something a little bit wrong. And that's a really helpful prompting process to utilize after the fact, once you've done your initial build. Build Agent isn't perfect, and so there are errors that it won't be able to initially catch. And so utilizing that format of when I attempt to do blank, I expect this to happen, but instead this error happens, is a great format to utilize when you're talking to Build Agent to be able to fix some of the errors that you find after the fact. Okay, so I want to also show you how to do a much more robust way of prompting on your initial prompt in case you want to be a little bit more exact with what you want Build Agent to do instead of just saying a simple sentence. To be able to do a much more robust initial prompt, you're going to want to go from within your ServiceNow instance. And to do that, go to developer.servicenow.com, and then you'll just click on Start Building to get into your ServiceNow instance. From within your ServiceNow instance, you're going to click on the All button in your filter navigator, and you're going to search for ServiceNow IDE to launch the ServiceNow IDE. Once you're in ServiceNow IDE, you're going to create a new workspace, give it a name, a description, and you're going to let Build Agent launch on the sidebar. And then from here, you can provide a much more robust prompt. You'll see here in my prompt, I have details of what tables I exactly want, what roles for security I want. I want specific user experiences, and I have a lot more detail about what I want this app to do. If you want a template of a good prompt, I have one provided on the ServiceNow developer blog, and that will be linked below in the description. But I'll take my robust prompt and submit it to Build Agent and approve it. And just like before, it's going to create its own scoped app within my workspace and start building out that app. And just like before, here's all of its completed features, including tables, roles, business logic, sample data, and next steps for it to complete. But for me, I actually wanted to create a UI for managers to quickly see these inventories. And I actually provide a little theme of a nice boba shoppe aesthetic. Warm, pastel palette, minimal gradients, and I ask it to build that UI for me. Build Agent utilizes a React framework to create the entire user interface that also dynamically pulls in the data from your ServiceNow instance. And just like that, it creates a new UI page for me, deployed directly inside of my instance, and also provides me a link to the UI so I can launch directly into it and see how it works. I can click on that link and jump right into this new UI, and there it is, a really cool, clean management screen for my boba app. And yes, this took me about 4 prompts to make. And speaking of prompts, you'll see that whenever you start getting closer to your usage limit, it'll actually start warning you on each prompt to let you know how many prompts you have left during your usage period. Something to be able to keep track of. If you've run out of usage because you've previously used your prompts before Build with Build Agent has started, you can actually reset your usage by going to developer.servicenow.com, clicking on Manage My Instance, and then clicking on Actions, Reset and Wipe Instance, Give Up My Instance, and Reset and Wipe. Just wait for the email letting you know that you have a new instance ready, and usage will be reset on that new instance. I want to say thank you again for joining me for this Build with Build Agent challenge, and I hope to see you soon. Bye.